Hey, everybody, and welcome to another episode of Time, Talent, Treasure Radio. I'm your host, Jared Sebesta of Taatjes Financial Group, where we build purposeful retirement plans. At Taatjes Financial Group, we believe retirement planning is so much more than just preparing financially. Our goal is to help retirees and pre-retirees steward their time, talent, and treasure. We have the tools and proven process to make sure your retirement plan delivers the greatest purpose, impact, and legacy. If you need help building a purposeful retirement plan specific for your life and your retirement, give us a call. Our number is 222-4236. You can request a meeting online at our website, taatjesfinancial.com. And if you are in the neighborhood, you can always stop by our office. We're located on 19th Avenue Southwest in Wilmer, building purposeful retirement plans. Well, thank you so much for joining us today. Hope you're having a wonderful day. This is a big time of the year, more specifically for our office, because our leader, Ben Taatjes, this is the time that you have your birthday every year, depending on when you're listening to this, but May 9th is your official birthday. So first of all, happy birthday. It's not a lot of fun to really give you a lot of guff about your age, because I'm about 6 months older than you. So no matter what age you reach, I'm always about 6 months ahead of you. But happy birthday. Hope you're having a great day.
Hey, thanks, buddy. I got good news for you. We're both old. We're both old. I mean, it feels that way. It's sometimes, I mean, I've been dealing with a daughter who went to prom. You know, all of a sudden she's 17. My other one's 15, and mm-hmm. she's starting to drive a little bit. So, yeah, it's crazy how quickly time goes. It seems like just yesterday they were just little girls. So every birthday you tend to reflect on things, don't you? You tend to think about your age and what's significant about your age. And I think me and you are both kind of in that, you know, mid-40s stage, mm-hmm. which says, hey, what have I done? What have I done in my life? And you look at your family and you start to, kind of reflect on those things. So that's where I'm at today.
Yeah, I would agree. I'm on the other end of the spectrum when it comes to children. We're expecting our fourth child in July. You've got kids in high school and almost you're a couple of years away from empty nesters, but there is something significant. I mean, you could call it a midlife crisis. There's been many names put on it, but there is something interesting about this phase of life where you realize you're not a kid anymore, but yet you have a lot of years left. And so I think it's a really interesting time to do a lot of self-reflecting. I think that we have done that, but it's a good age. I mean, I feel good. Again, we got lots of life left. And I'm just kind of ready to just take the next step. And so, I mean, this is kind of neat. You know, a lot of people don't know this. You and I are the oldest people in our office as well. So I don't know if that's scary or good or bad or indifferent.
Well, you always want to work with somebody that's going to be there when you need them. And I think a lot of our clients like that about our office, is we are younger. You know, I've got 20 years of experience, so I'm not young. But certainly with most of our retired clients, they're like, you know, it's kind of like that, hey, I want a doctor that's a little bit younger, number one. They've just been through some of the schooling. They're up on all their, important continuing ed, all that good stuff. But yet, when I get sick, older in my age, then I'm going to want that same person there to take care of me. So I've heard a lot of clients talk about that with us, that they appreciate that we're a younger firm. I love it. I love our chemistry in our office here, the people here, and you and I being the oldest of our, exactly. it is interesting, but it makes for a really fun atmosphere, and we get a ton done, I think, that with our people here. So it is good. And as I reflect on age again, I mean, we're not quite to that. You know, I think it would typically, we start getting really more intense meetings with clients in their 50s and 60s, because there's so many things, and as we're going to talk about their ages and as they change, all the planning opportunities that come up. You know, right now, though, and for younger people, mm-hmm. it's about putting money away. When you look at the retirement planning world, it's those younger years, so much can be done the earlier you start. So I've loved the last 20 years doing this, and it's just a reflection today on ages, I guess.
You kind of set up today's show really well. We want to talk about some specific ages in light of your birthday, and there are certain ages that do become a little bit more, I don't want to say important, but things that people need to be on the lookout for, and this starts about the age of 50. Why don't you kind of get us going with this conversation?
Yeah, Jerry, I think that first one, a few years off, thankfully, for you and I, but a few years from now, you're going to be able to contribute more into your retirement plan. So whether or not you have an IRA, 403B, 401K, any qualified plan typically has some what we call catch-up contributions starting at age 50. So that's the first birthday. I think you gotta, I'm not saying you're finally old enough, but I mean, the IRS is saying you're old enough to really get serious about saving, and they're allowing you to put a little bit more in. Each plan is a little different and unique. And what I would tell you to do is just research that, ask some questions of your HR department if you're, you know, within a 401k or working space, or do your own research, figure out what your catch-up contribution is once you hit age 50.
So that's at 50, and I've always known since I opened up my first Roth IRA back when I was in my 20s, 59 and a half is kind of that next big step, isn't it?
Yeah, 59 and a half is where you're no longer penalized for withdrawals. So if you were to take money out of a qualified retirement account, there is not a penalty there anymore. So yes, if it's a traditional IRA or 403b, there would be taxes, but you're not, there's not that extra 10% penalty for being quote unquote too young to use your retirement account.
So after 59 and a half, there's kind of a jump there. And we'll talk about Social Security just in a second here with regards to your 60s, but let's jump to your 70s because that's kind of the next significant age.
Yeah, when you look at retirement accounts, 70 and a half is still an important age. So when you turn 70 and a half, it used to be the age in which you were, you know, the IRS said, now you have to start taking money out of your retirement accounts. Those are called RMDs. Now that age is pushed off. We'll talk about that in a second. But 70 and a half is still an important age because you're still allowed to do qualified charitable distributions. Now these are something that we do a ton of them in our office, where we're sending money directly from an IRA to a qualified charity. And that age is still 70 and a half and beyond. You can send up to $100,000 to a charity per year.
And required minimum distributions start at 72, but it gets a little convoluted now with depending on your birthday, right?
Yeah, it changed. So if you turn 72 before December 31 of 2022, 72 is your required minimum distribution age. However, if you turn 72 after December 31, 2022, now 73 is actually the new required minimum distribution age. So again, important there if you're 72 or 73, just figure out, again, working with your tax professional, your advisor, do I have an RMD or don't I? And I think that's really important. Mm-hmm. And you also have a little more time there up until April 1st, that first year. So just get to know those rules a little bit on distributions. But again, 72 or 73 going forward, it's going to be 73 for a little while.
All right. So let's rewind back to our 60s. That's when we get into more of the Social Security ages.
Yeah, Jared. And it used to be that people would come in and they'd say, you know, I'm about 65 and it's time to retire, because that's just when people retire. And when, you know, realize your age really shouldn't be the determinant of if you can retire or not. It is an important thing with Social Security, but not necessarily when you can choose to retire. So when you, the first time which you can take Social Security benefits is at age 62. Then there's this age, whether it be 66 and some months up to in your 70s, and this is changing all the time, depending on your date of birth, this is when you hit your full retirement age. And that's an important age so that the income limits won't matter when they look at if you're pulling Social Security. And then finally, age 70, that's really when you hit your maximum Social Security benefits. And you should at least be taking them then, because they will not go up anymore after that point.
You know, so many people, they'll say this, and I'll hear this, you know, out in the community as I talk to people, you know, I'm turning 65, so it's time to retire. Let's just end the show by saying, you know, your age shouldn't dictate when you decide to retire. How should people frame that in their mind?
Yeah, 65, really the only thing you have to be thinking about at age 65 is Medicare, right? And 3 months before, you should be looking at that. But 65 is not retirement age, quote unquote. Just because the federal government has set an arbitrary age, whether it be 62 or 65 or your full retirement age, that is just the government saying when they think you can retire. You have to make that decision yourself based on your own financial situation, looking at your own retirement goals, and then develop a plan to make sure your retirement is what you thought it would be.
All right. Thank you so much, Ben, and happy birthday once again. Well, are you between these key ages of 50 and 65 years old and are ready to begin building a purposeful retirement plan that will best steward your time, your talent, and treasure? If so, we can help.
We have a number of ways that you can set up a no-cost, no-obligation meeting. First, you can give us a call at 320-222-4236. You can go to our brand new website, taatjesfinancial.com, and request a meeting. Or if you live in West Central Minnesota, we're located on 19th Avenue Southwest in Wilmer, office hours Monday through Friday, 8:30 to 4:30. I'm Jared Sebesta, joining you on this episode of Time, Talent, Treasure Radio. Thanks for listening. We'll see you next time.
Securities offered through Avantax Investment Services, member FINRA, SIPC. Investment advisory services offered through Avantax Advisory Services. Insurance services offered through an Avantax-affiliated insurance agency.